Welcome to this video. In this video, we'll talk about how to send the PLC values to the IBM Cloud. And if you remember my last sessions, we have used PLC NextTrainer for getting the value from Raspberry Pi. So I'm continuing this lesson. So if you haven't seen the last lessons, so I would really recommend you to see lecture number 13 and 14. Because in this lecture 15, we are going to use these values and we send it to the cloud. And in the cloud services, we are using IBM Cloud. Okay, so let's see what we have in this video. We will see, first of all, how to send data from PLC to the cloud, okay? And then later on, we'll see how to send the data from cloud back to PLC. So this lesson is split into two lectures. So in this lesson, we will see how to send the data from PLC to the cloud. And then in the next video, we'll see the opposite side of it. And the interesting thing is, we also have a cloud simulator, which I'm going to introduce you during this lesson, all right? So, and this lesson can be used in a way, for example, if you have a PLC and you are getting some values and you want to send this value to a different location, how you can do that. For example, if you see in this slideshow, I'll go full screen. Now I will take a pointer. And let's say you want to send the values from your PLC, which is, for example, if you are using PLC Next, and we are having a value, let's say humidity, or maybe temperature, which is coming from this PLC, and you want to send this value to a remote location. Let's say this remote location is, for example, we are sending the value to Australia. There is a plant in Australia, and we want to send this value, and this PLC is located in Germany. So to reach from Germany to Australia, we go via cloud. So we send the value to the cloud, and this cloud can be located in any location. You know, it can be any location, and it is always preferred to store this value in the nearest location, okay? So this can be in multiple locations. Let's say it's stored in Germany as well. So this in Germany itself, we have various cloud services. There's a cloud backup where you send the values, okay? So we send the values to this cloud, and now when the values are in the cloud, this is like on the internet, www, and then you can send the value in any location, which could be, let's say, Australia in this case. So then from the cloud, it goes back to Australia. So we can do direct linkage between these two countries, but if you're using cloud services, we send the value to the cloud, and from the cloud we can send to multiple locations. That's the benefit. And cloud services has many benefits. They have different benefits, like you can have automatic analytics, and you have a SQL database as well in this cloud. If you do it directly between these two, then you have to do some router settings and open your ports and stuff like that. But in this lesson, we'll see how to use IBM Cloud to send the values. Okay, so let's see what other things required, and we proceed step by step. So we go to the next slide. Hardware use. So I'm using PLC NextTrainer. So it has a PLC inside. It has IOs and digital IOs and NUG IOs and a potentiometer and some switches. So if you've seen my last videos, I've explained how this PLC NextTrainer works. Okay. And then I'm using a Raspberry Pi. Raspberry Pi because we have some sensors, which is temperature. Oh, sorry, there is a mistake in the spelling. Temperature sensor and humidity. So these sensors are connected to my Raspberry Pi, and then PLC will read from this Raspberry Pi. So it will read the value, read temperature and humidity. So PLC will read from this, and then it will send further to the cloud, okay? So these are the hardware I'm using, and in the software you need Node-RED. So In my example, I have already installed Node-RED in PLC Next. So the software is already inside in this PLC Next. So Node-RED is inside this. So I'm gonna use that one, okay? And then you need IBM Cloud. So you need an account, which you can make for free. And there are some free services which you can use. So this is the software requirement, and that's the hardware requirement. Then comes the step of execution, how to proceed. Step one, read the values in Node-RED. So I'm gonna show you from my last example. Let's go. back. And if you remember from my last video examples, I have the values coming in my Node-RED for the temperature and humidity. So these are the values which are coming from Raspberry Pi, which I'm reading via MQTT. So MQTT between PLC Next and Raspberry Pi. So this is explained in the last lesson. So once we need to make sure which values we want to send to the cloud. So in this case, I have humidity and temperature. Okay. Now, before I send this value to the cloud, let's see a simulation. So I have a link here. You can also just check this link. Developer.ibm.com recipe tutorials use the simulated device to experience the IoT foundation. So when you open this link, you will have a web page like this. So I'm just showing you an example of a simulation of sending the values to the cloud. So the first step is you have to open this link, and it has some sensors inside. For example, temperature, and then you have humidity, and you have temperature again, object temperature. So this temperature value you can change from here. So like 17 degree, 20, 21, 22, 23, and humidity you can also change. So this is just a simulator. And then you open visualizing your data. And here you open this link. So now in this link, you will have the values which will come from these sensors. So it's just a kind of explanation. So what I will do is I will just take out this tab outside so I can show you simultaneously two values. So this is like this, and this is here. Now, if you notice, I have to put this ID here, so I will get the values of humidity. So I will just copy this, put it here, and click go. And now you will see the values will start generating here. Okay, it automatically took all the values, temperature, humidity, and object. But this is the ID, so this is 78%. So if I click on this one, click go. What's wrong with the page? Let me refresh. Yeah, check this humidity. This is 78% at the moment, you can see here. So if I increase, then you can see the value is 80%. So this is a visualization, and that's the link on the internet. That's the link on the internet. So basically, whatever we see here, for example, object temperature, 26, you can see 26 here. And if you want to see on the graph, just click this one, and then you have the value coming. So this is creating automatically visualizing the value on the IBM cloud services. What we're going to do is now, instead of this simulation, we're going to use our own sensor, which is installed in Raspberry Pi, and see the values here. That's the first step. So let's go for that. I will bring this guy back to this browser. So coming back to our slide, we were at step one, read values in Node-RED. So in Node-RED, we already have our values. So I'll close the simulation. So that's my Node-RED. And if you see, the values are coming here. This is my temperature, and that's my humidity. Temperature and humidity. So we have these value here already, and this is local. This is not on the internet at the moment. This is currently in my PLC Next. Okay. So now proceed to the next step. Make an account in IBM Cloud. Okay. There are two ways to see the values in the cloud. One is you make an account and register your virtual IIoT device. Okay, I will come to that bit later. But now let's see how to send these values, these two values, here in this graph. For this, you don't need an account. Okay, let's see the first step, the scratch in which you don't need an account. So you can just open this this simulation link and click on this box, click on this link here, and you will have this window. Okay, now you need this ID. So how to get this ID? So we will create this ID for our own temperature and humidity values. So how you can do that? So go to Node-RED, and you have to install a plugin which will show you Watson IoT input and output. So I can show you what I have installed. So you need to install this Node-RED Contrib IBM Watson IoT. So once you install this, you will see these input and output. So I need an output. So I will take this output here. It's very simple. Just drag it in your programming window and link it to your humidity. And you have to open this. Go for quick start device. Quick start, it's already defined. And this is automatically generated. click Done and click Deploy. So it will show connected. Once it's connected, open this one, copy this ID, and go to this device, this window, paste this ID here, and click Go. Once you do that, you will see the values are coming here. So it's 31.6. This is the humidity. And if I want to show you, like this here. So this is the values generated on the cloud for the quick start device in which you don't need any programming. So this is now 31.7. So this is reading from my Raspberry, from my PLC Next. Okay, because in my PLC Next, I have my Node-RED in which I took this node and I just pushed the values. So this will be seen here. Quite easy, quite simple. You can do the same for temperature. So I'll take this one out and I will to connect this here. Or what you can also do is you can just connect the temperature value directly to this device and click deploy. So when I open this now, I have to maybe refresh it. So now you can see this is a temperature value. But in case if you want to see both the values, you have to write a function. So I can show you that. You have to write a function in JSON. So in JSON, you have to define two events, two parameters, and then two values. So let me show you that quickly, how to write that function, because this is one device and you're having multiple values. So it's actually taking the second value, but it's not taking the humidity. So let's write a function. So what I will do is I will open a function here. And here I have to write a message. So I have to write the message in JSON format. So it will be message.payload. And then I take an object. So I have written a sample program here. So I will take another object. Object name is D. D is my standard object. And then I will write humidity. I have to check the payload and temperature. So these are my two parameters. Now, what will be the value inside it? I need to check it first. So this is message.payload number. Okay, I have to define this. Because I am getting two payloads, which are just message.payload. So I will write. Or what I can do is, wait, that will be more easy. I will move these values in a global variable. Okay, so let me just use that quickly. Global.set humidity message.payload. Or I can take just the number. And I will store this P because the value is coming in string. So I will use P and this should be okay. Let me just cross check. Yeah. So now what's going to happen? The humidity will be stored in P and then this P is stored in a global variable called humidity. So I will write set global humidity. This will be stored here. Similarly, I will set the temperature as a global variable. In this case, I will just change the variable temperature. Now I have two variables in which the values are coming. So I can show you here. Just confirm deploy. Text data. And these are my global variables, humidity and temperature. Now I'm going to read this variable and put it here. So I will write variable humidity global dot, I hope it was read. Oh no, global dot get, sorry. Humidity and should be okay. Similarly, I will read temperature. And I will put here humidity. And temperature. So now I have these two values here. Okay, sorry, this will not be semicolon. And oops, this will be semicolon here, colon, sorry. Yeah, so I have my humidity and temperature, which is coming from global variable. So this variable, you can use anything here. This should be not humidity, temperature. So I took two variables which are reading from global variables, temperature and humidity, and then I'm using it in a JSON format and sending it to the cloud. Okay, everything looks okay, click done. So now I have these two values here. And this IoT guy will come here. So this I can also use a timestamp. So I will send the value after every 1 second. And this will go to the cloud. Click deploy. If you want to see the values which are going, I can show you here. Okay, let's close these two guys and let's see. So this is the object which has humidity and temperature. Okay, so you can see these values are going to my device. Now I will open my device. Here you can see these two values are coming, so let me just click go again. This was the last values. Let me refresh it. Okay, so you have temperature and you have humidity. These are these two values which are going to the cloud. So if you have multiple parameters which you want to see in a single web page, you have to make a JSON format. That was the idea of telling you that. So this is right now showing the humidity. If I click on temperature, now the temperature will be shown. So these are the multiple values which you can see on the IBM cloud. But now this was just going to as a quick register device. Okay, as a quick device, we did not register any device on the cloud. So this is not so secure. This is just to see as a demo and as an example to get the values on the cloud. So what you can do is, once you have done this, you can share this link to your friends or to somewhere where you just want to show the values, okay? And just share this ID. This ID is generated in your Node-RED, this ID. So share the link, share the ID, and you can share the values to somebody you want. This is just a scratching way, or a starting way, to show how to push the value to the cloud. But in the next video, this video is getting long. In the next video, I will show you how to create a device, a customized device on the IBM Cloud Services by making an account and send the value in a bit securely. All right, so we'll see that in the next video. Thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.